Welcome to my YouTube channel. This time we are going to learn how to create this incredible effect with Adobe Photoshop. Let's start. Let's start by creating a file with the following measurements displayed on the screen. Then we drag the two images that we leave in the video description, and with Ctrl plus the T key we adjust the images as seen on the screen. We put the image layer of the city on top and lower its opacity to be able to modify it better. Then we go to Edit, Transform and click on Warp to be able to distort the image as seen on screen and give it that arc shape to match the umbrella. Now we apply a clipping mask and with the brush tool we eliminate the lower areas of the image. Now we select the subject layer and we go to Image, Adjustment and click on Levels to modify the levels of the image as seen on the screen. Then we select the city layer and lower the saturation by going to Image, Adjustment and clicking on Hue Saturation. In the same way we lower the saturation to the image of the subject. Now in the subject layer we right-click and rasterize the image. Then we go to Image, Adjustment and select Match Color to match the colors of the image. Here we select the file where we are working and the color reference layer and change the values as seen on the screen. In the city layer, we apply curves to darken the image a little, and with the brush we continue to eliminate some areas to achieve a better fusion of images. We also apply a curve effect on all layers, lowering the opacity until obtaining an optimal result. Then we apply a hue saturation effect. Click on the top icon on the left to select the color of the jacket and give it a red color. Select the layer mask for this effect and invert it by clicking Ctrl plus the I key, and with a blank brush we color the entire area of the jacket. We can remove areas of the city with the brush until we are satisfied with the mixture of the images. We apply a hue saturation effect to lower the saturation to all images. We also apply curve effect to darken all the layers, invert the layer mask of the effect, and with the brush we only darken some parts as shown on screen. We apply a curve effect again, but this time to lighten the image and invert its layer mask, and with the blank brush reveal the lighter areas. Now we apply a color lookup effect to apply a more cinematic filter. Then we click Ctrl plus Shift plus the Alt key plus the E key to get a layer with all the effects applied. We go to Filter and open the Camera Raw filter. In Camera Raw filter we apply the values that are seen on the screen. Then we lower the noise to the entire image, increasing the luminance as shown in the video. Perfect! We have finished this effect. If you liked this video, leave us your like and subscribe to this channel where you can find more effects like this. Thanks for the support.